It's no secret that AYRO has absolutely skyrocketed in value recently. They've gone straight to the moon, and to a certain extent, I don't think it's that shocking. For a very quick overview, they make these light-duty, small electric trucks. They're not trying to make commuter vehicles or anything like that. These are smaller utility vehicles. I've actually made two videos about this company before. One of them was back on August 7th. And the other one was on October 21st. So if you want to know more about the company, these are my detailed overviews. I'll have a link in the description, and I'll also have something in the title card of this video. But for the rest of this video, I'm going to assume you're pretty well informed about the company. AYRO has soared. In 5 days, they've gone from less than $4 to over $10. It's really incredible the huge spikes we've seen. And when I talked about this company previously, it was pretty cheap. On October 21st, they had a high of under $3. That's the last video I made about them. And the oldest video I made about them on August 7th, they had a high of $4.44. Honestly, a lot of things about this company really impressed me, at least in the EV space. There were so many companies out there that were not actually selling products or had any sort of big, proper partnership or contract that would distribute products. It was kind of infuriating to see so many companies going public without actually doing anything. AYRO, on the other hand, had actually been setting up and dealing with tons and tons of contracts. The first one I talked about was their partnership with Club Car and how they're making the 411 utility vehicle. This was a pretty massive contract since Club Car is so huge, and they seem to be selling quite well. Additionally, that $600,000 gallery carts contract I talked about previously actually went super well too. They landed that contract in full, and they've been using them for a while. The deal has only developed further and further. If you're unfamiliar, Gallery is food trucks. So they worked on these tiny electric food trucks together using the 411 platform. Additionally, they started working with Karma Automotive, a Chinese company that bought tons and tons of things from the bankruptcy auction of the now defunct Fisker Automotive. I actually have a whole video detailing the new Fisker and all of those other things. I'll have a card and a link in the description if you're interested, but again, let's get back to AYRO because it's been crazy. And really, that's been the running theme of the videos. This company has established tons and tons of these pretty huge, high-profile contracts. And that's one thing that kind of blew me away about them is they really had no social media presence at all. It was hard to find videos about their product and other stuff. Yet they were sorting out all these contracts, and that sort of seemed to be their approach. They really were not concerning themselves with the consumer market. Their big concern was landing contracts and producing their vehicles, expanding their factory and production lines. And it paid off. They just recently announced this $10 million direct stock offering. Essentially, the Chinese company that owns Karma Automotive has this huge contract where they're working together. And evidently, they were happy to the point where they actually want to purchase tons and tons of AYRO stock. The purchase price is at $6.06 per share. There's also this whole warrant system that involves other strike prices associated with stock purchases. But warrant systems do get pretty complex and messy. If you're an investor and you're really concerned about these, I would read through in detail. But to make a long story short, they received a lot of investment money. They have a lot of contracts. And evidently, there are some big hands pushing a lot of cash into this company. With Tesla joining the S&P 500, the electric vehicle market has really been a craze. All of these publicly traded companies have been absolutely skyrocketing in value. It's really been staggering, and thus we get this huge growth. To a certain extent, I kind of felt like this was inevitable. This company really seemed to be managed quite well. They weren't being obsessed with trying to push up their stock price or do other stupid things. They were producing products and getting contracts done, selling things, you know, doing what a company has to do. You don't just hype things as a company. You sell product. You sell value. And they skyrocketed in value. I imagine they're going to hold a higher share price. The reality of the market is that all reactions are an overreaction. I would not be surprised if we see a dip. But I'm not certain that the $6 price mark is going to be the new norm for them. I'm expecting them to stay above that $6 going in the future. Now, that's barring any unforeseen circumstances. If something comes out about the company that's seriously bad, well, there's always a possibility any stock you own can drop to zero. But they've established themselves pretty well, and with so many people wanting to dump money into the EV space, it looks like this was really one of the casualties that shot up. A huge congratulations if you invested in this company. You just made yourself a lot of money. You could always cash out now for the gains or see where it goes in the future. Again, I wouldn't be super surprised if we see a dip, especially across the entire EV space, but we are starting to see that big money really wants in on the electric vehicle market. And we're not just talking about road vehicles. In fact, that might be a smaller part of the market for many companies that aren't set up to create passenger vehicles. Selling a passenger car that's competitive is very, very difficult. But these smaller utility vehicles, that's a whole different ballgame. And that might be an area more well suited for disruption, especially as regulators get more and more restrictive on internal combustion engine vehicles. Really, I'm glad to see this company's doing well. And if you invested, hey, congratulations. I'm super happy for you. It's always exciting when a company just shoots up in value. But again, all reactions are overreactions. Although, maybe we do see things pop up higher. If you're interested in getting into the market and using self-directed trading, a fantastic way to start is with Webull. If you sign up now, you can get 3 free stocks. I have a referral link in the description, and again, if you sign up, you can get a free stock valued between $2.50 to $250, and then you'll receive 2 other free stocks valued between $8 and $1,600 if you deposit $100 or more. There are no fees or anything with depositing money. You just get your stocks. If you're interested and want access to a fantastic trading desktop, mobile, and web application, just use the link in the description below.